Hi and welcome to another World of Warcraft video. Today I'm going to give you some tips for new World of Warcraft Classic players to make your game adventure more enjoyable. These tips are important because if you approach the game the wrong way and with wrong expectations, it may feel too challenging and very often even boring. But there is a way to have a lot of fun in this game and enjoy most of your time that you spend playing it, especially during leveling. So without wasting more time for long introductions, let's get started. Before creating your first character, you must first choose a server or a realm. There are three important factors for choosing a realm: preferred language, where are your friends playing, and the server population. Server population has impact on many aspects of the game, for example, group activities like dungeons, raids and battlegrounds, number of active guilds, auction house activity, and supply and demand for different items. So if you don't want to play in a single player mode, I highly recommend choosing a server with higher population. In order to do that, make a quick research, because even if you see that a certain server has population status high or even full, it doesn't mean that it is full with players from the faction you're going to play. You can check the official forums of the servers and see if you can find updated information about the population, the community and guild activity. There are also some websites that provide such information. I'm not sure how accurate they are, but they can provide some ideas about from where to start your research. Don't rush. Don't think about leveling speed or efficiency. Enjoy every level and aspect of the game. Explore new zones, level and develop professions. Try some PvP. Go to dangerous places where you can interact with players from the opposing faction. Gather resources and craft different items. Learn how to make gold through the auction house. Join group activities like dungeons and battlegrounds. Communicate with people and you may also find some new friends. If you play with the only idea to reach level 60, you will have a terrible and boring experience during the leveling process, and you will miss many opportunities to enjoy the game. Just play and do whatever you like, no matter how it impacts your leveling speed. Nobody will stop you from enjoying the game alone, but remember that you may miss a lot if you don't try to find other people to play with. Join a guild. If you don't like it, join another. Eventually, you may find a guild with people that you enjoy playing with, and you can even find real friends among them. Dungeons, raids and battlegrounds are very fun to play modes, and it is even better if you can play them with guild members or friends. Train cooking and fishing skills and make your own food and drinks. That will save you a lot of gold. In WoW Classic you will have to drink and eat very often, but food and drinks are not cheap and you need that gold for more important things. Also develop your first aid skills, which will help you to quickly recover after a tough fight. Because spells use a lot of mana in WoW Classic and you often need to drink, don't forget to buy and use a wand if you play as a mage, warlock or priest. Check the auction house for a wand appropriate for your level and at an affordable price. Some wands are very powerful and are a good replacement for some of your spells when you are out of mana. Activate auto-loot if you don't want to waste time for clicking each mob for the loot. You can turn this feature on in game menu, interface and control settings. Pick at least one gathering profession as soon as possible. You will need gold for many important things, and these professions will let you gather and sell resources in auction house. It is not a mistake to even pick two gathering professions till you reach endgame or decide which crafting profession to develop. A good combination is skinning and mining. With skinning, you will collect and sell different kind of leather and hides while you level and fight with beasts. Ores that come from mining are also in high demand even in early game. With 3 or 4 stacks of copper ore, you can make your first 1 gold in auction house. Don't buy and upgrade unnecessary spells or abilities that you think you will not be using during leveling. Choose spells that are appropriate for your chosen gamestyle, rotation and talents. For example, if you are going to play mainly as a frost mage, you don't need to upgrade all fire or arcane spells. Try different classes and play those who you enjoy most. Don't play something that other players are expecting you to play. Yes, unfortunately in WoW Classic, classes are not balanced. In group activities, such as raids and dungeons, there are some classes that are preferred for specific roles. For example, warriors are the preferred tanks, priests are expected to heal, and mages and rogues are often the preferred damage dealers. But that doesn't mean that you can't play and have fun as druid or paladin and find groups. It may be harder, but it is not impossible. More important is to like and enjoy your character's game style and abilities. Boosts are a common thing in WoW Classic, used for faster leveling or collecting specific items and resources. Some players with high-level characters provide free boosts, while others are asking for gold. Yes, this is a much faster way to clear a dungeon, but I don't think that there is much fun in that. The most enjoyable way to clear a dungeon is with players that have characters with the same level as yours. Use trait and looking for group channels to search for dungeon groups. You can join looking for group channel in two ways. By typing /join looking for group and press enter in the chat, or by using the chat channels menu. While not all players know and use this channel, it will help you to find groups while questing outside the main cities. In order to use the trait channel, you must be in one of those major cities. Plan and take all fight paths that are on your way. In WoW Classic, you often need to travel from one zone to another and from one continent to another. Having the key fight paths will save you a lot of time for traveling. For example, if you are at the western part of Illwing Forest, you are close to Westfall, and it is a good idea to go there and take the fight path. You will need it later when you reach the appropriate character level. Make one or two oaths that you can use to store different items and resources. Upgrading the bank slots is very expensive, and you can send by email all items that you currently don't need to those oaths. You can make one oath for resources and one for other type of items. Choice is yours. Save enough gold for the riding skill and amount that will significantly increase your traveling speed. You can learn this skill and buy amount when you reach level 40. You will need around 100 gold for both, unless you play with Paladin or Warlock, which receive free mounts at level 40. That's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you find it valuable, please leave a like and consider subscribing to my channel for more content like this. Thanks again for watching. Enjoy your WoW Classic adventure, and I'll see you in the next video.